Hello! In this video, we'll be showing you how to paint the Cawdor Ridge Walkers, getting them on the table, charging around the ash wastes of Necromunda. The first thing we'll need to do is undercoat the model, and for this we've used lead belcher, so it's easier to paint the Ridge Walker itself as it's a mass of metal parts. We'll be painting the Ridge Walker and the Way Brethren exactly the same time. This is due to how the model is built. So if it's easier for you, watch each paint step first before applying any paint to the model. You can always re-watch a step later. The 10 paints you'll need are on the screen right now. Remember that these are recommendations. Feel free to paint these models however you like. If you are new to painting and want to know the types of paint and techniques used in this video, check out our Citadel Colour Painting Essentials videos in the description. First, we'll start off by using lead belcher all over the Ridge Walker and any of the metallic areas on the Way Brethren, and we'll be using our Citadel Medium base brush for all this. As we are painting over an undercoat of lead belcher already, we just want a nice thin coat of this, as the pot version has a slightly different finish to the spray, so it may not look very different right now. We do this just in case we make a mistake on the metalwork, so we can always tidy up and get the same end result. It doesn't matter if we're a little bit messy with this step, as long as we get a nice finish to that layer. Next, we'll apply Brass Scorpion to any areas we want to be a different metallic colour. This can be anywhere you want, but if you want some ideas, you can always check out the box art for some help. We'll use our small base brush for this, as some of these details are quite small and in hard to reach places. With this colour, we'll need a few layers to get that solid metallic coverage. When we're finished with our metallic paints, it's best to change our paint water to avoid any of those metallic flakes getting into our next colours. Brass Scorpion is a layer paint, but it is the perfect colour we need for some battered, Hive World scrap brass. After our metallics are dry, we can move on to Mephiston Red for the suspension coils and any small details found on the Way Brethren, such as his mask. We'll need a couple of layers of this paint to get full coverage over that metallic base paint. As some of these details are in hard to reach places, or quite small, we'll need our small Citadel base brush for all of these. Mephiston Red may seem too bright right now, but we'll make it look grim dark with some shading later on. Next, we'll use Macragge Blue for the blue details, such as some of the Walker panels and the hood for the Way Brethren. We can use a combination of a small and medium base brush for this, depending on the size of the area we're painting on. By using the right size brush for the area, we can avoid making any mistakes on the areas we've just painted. It's fine though if we do make any mistakes, as it's a super easy fix by using the paints we've previously used. Just like the paint before, we want to get a couple of coats on, so we get that nice solid blue colour. Now we'll be applying Wraithbone to any of the wrappings, skin, boots, backpack and ropes on the whole model. This is a lot of areas to cover, so we'll be taking our time and applying multiple layers to get a solid colour and to avoid missing any of those small details. Check the box art to see where these details may be on your Ridge Walker of choice. Try to be as neat as you can, as it will save time tidying up, but mistakes can be rectified easily by going back with the previous colours. Wraithbone is a great base paint with light creamy tones, which is perfect for the shade and contrast paints we'll be using next. Next, we'll use Agrax Earthshade over the wrappings, ropes, the brass and the red details using our small layer brush. If the colour is a little bit too dark on those wrappings, we can always thin it down with some water. One part Agrax Earthshade to two parts water will be lighter and will look great on those details. It's easier to add layers of lighter shades rather than to fix one that's too dark. Wait till that first layer is dry before adding your second layer if you wish. Agrax Earthshade is perfect for making lighter colours on this model look grimy but still keep some warm tones to that base coat. Now we can apply Gillam of Flesh to any of our Way Brethren's skin, using the same brush as we did before. Applying this before any of the contrasts mean that we can get into those tricky to reach areas, and don't have to worry about fixing any minor mistakes. This means if we do get a small amount of the skin colour on the Wraithbone cloth, we can easily cover it with our next paints. Just be careful around those wrappings we've just painted. We've chosen this colour for the skin as it matches the box art, but feel free to choose whichever skin tone you like for your miniatures. You could use Dark Oath Flesh, Fire Slave Flesh, or Cygore Brown instead. Next, we'll use Black Legion in two ways. We'll use it straight from the pot for any boots, clothing and gun casings. As not all of the Way Brethren have boots, or more than one piece of cloth to their name, you can always mix and match for some diverse colour schemes for your whole unit. If you'd rather stick to the box art, that's great too. We'll also thin down one part Black Legion to three parts water to make a great shade for our silver, metal and blue panels. Black Legion is a very versatile contrast paint, as it's a neutral tone but very heavy, so it's great for using straight out of the pot or thinned down for a lighter shade. When that's dry, we can move on to Wildwood for the backpacks and any other clothing too. This creates a super dark and rich leather tone in one coat. We want a good layer of this contrast paint on the model, but move it around so it gets into all of those details and recesses. If it's pooling too much though, just soak it up with a clean damp brush, and reapply some more if needed. Once it's dry, if you think the area looks a little bit too light, you can always add a thin layer over the top. Just like with the other colours that we have used, you can use them in any combination on the model to make them unique in the unit, just giving them that little bit extra character. When those contrast paints are dry, you can stop right there and you'll have some awesome looking models. Or we can add some extra detail by highlighting the blue details with a Latok blue. We'll be using a small layer brush for this, as we want to keep control of our paint and get a nice point to the tip of our brush. We'll thin it down slightly with a drop of water, so it's not too thick on our brush. This will help it keep flowing for longer, from brush to model. We can do this by rolling the brush on the palette. This can also help us by not overloading our brush full of paint. We can use the side of the brush for any edges, and the tip of the brush to make any little scratches in the paintwork, just by making little marks. If we make any mistakes, or the lines look a little bit too thick, just go back over with some thinned down macrag blue and let it dry. And there we are, your Cawdor Ridge Walker is finished and looking fantastic. You can see that our model is based in Armageddon Dunes, but you can base it in any colours you want. If you'd like to learn more about basing, check out our technical paints video all about it. For more tutorials, tips and techniques, head to citadelcolour.com. Or you can also head to a Warhammer store, where our friendly staff can offer you more help. Well, I hope you enjoyed this video, and we'll see you next time. Bye-bye!